First of all, I'm actually not a sketcher. I mean, I can, but it'll look terrible. And I guess, but I never was, even pre-computer in school. I was much more about, let's work with the actual typography, let's, you know, if I'm going to distort it, let's distort it on the stat camera or do this or do that, as opposed to like drawing it out. But the whole All-Star line was, we knew who the artists were going to be. The writers and the artists. And it was going to start out with Superman and Batman. There was talk of it going beyond that. But I wanted them to look good together. Like if you took All-Star Superman and you put it next to All-Star Batman, you get the confluence of the logos that kind of go into each other. And again, like, that's just me. I mean, that was something that I was doing more for myself than for anything else. But it tied it together conceptually for me. And I also wanted to bring back the idea of the space at the top is where the typography is, and then the image is underneath that and separated from it. Basically, you can do so much, and then they take it from there, and they rework it from month to month, and that's just the way it is, and that's the reality of them having to publish this stuff from month to month. And then Superman wins the Eisner, so then they put the big Eisner winner sticker on the front, which, okay, fine, but, from the design purity, it sort of played havoc with that. I was concentrating on Superman and Batman and Robin the Boy Wonder as opposed to All-Star Superman and All-Star Batman and Robin the Boy Wonder. And that, I think, probably caused problems from the get-go. But I very much underplayed All-Star. And for the comics themselves, that's the way it went. But then for reprinting and trades and that kind of stuff, they made the All-Star much, much larger. But to me, it was always about, here's Superman by Grant Morrison and Frank Quitely, here's Batman and Robin by Frank Miller and Jim Lee. Like, that was always really, to me, what the deal was.